Alrighty, what's going on, everybody? As you already know. What's good, everybody? You already know this. You are Mr. E, and we're gonna be coming at y'all tonight on Revolutionary Hour with Childish Gambino. This is America. As we give our personal breakdown and interpretations of a magnificent piece of art, if you ask me personally. So y'all make sure y'all tune in. It's going to be going down soon. This is the Revolutionary Hour. You already know how we do it.
This is the Revolutionary Hour. B.O.S.S. Southside Boss Radio. Southside Boss Radio.
Out here in the trenches, every day trying to get it. We live and die for the dollar. They say money is the root.
Get it.
Feeling like Omar Epps when Pac fell off the roof.
Got to
live with no regrets. What a real nigga do. That's cause and effect. Some choose to break the rules. I'm blessed with the Jews. Use the pain as my fuel.
Uh-huh.
10 youngers on the corner pushing work. Call them muse. Shawty rather catch a dollar. Learn that shit in school. On the crime by the bills. Rent too much overdue. I hear the money calling niggas.
It's time to make power moves.
Power moves. If the streets is what you choose. Just know one day your dog may turn on you.
Your dog may turn on you.
For that dollar, I'ma let the angels holler.
Holler.
I see it every day. These youngins out here starving, looking for a better way. Unaware of the knowledge. I know tomorrow ain't promised. I hope God hears calling. We live and die for the dollar. We live and die for the dollar. We live and die for the dollar. Live and die for the dollar. Single mother struggling with two, one in the oven. Depression's on daddy, not home all of a sudden. She hold it down, wearing a crown. Can't tell her nothing like a jungle. Makes her wonder how she keep from going under. Convicted felon, lost hope on his last appeal. Moving dope to provide his family a decent meal. God, is he wrong for surviving, getting it how he lived? Doing 34, birdie locked behind the cold steel. Working the white man's job, they treat you like a slave. You feel the pain on your back without the whips and chains. This shit ain't designed for you, it's all commercial gain. We live and die for the dollar, call it minimum wage. Dear God, these crackers trying to kill us. Bring down Exodus before they squeeze another trigger. Technology brainwashing all my little children. Planting bad seeds, corrupting minds by the millions.
Do you feel
it every day? These youngins out here starving, looking for a better way. Unaware of the knowledge. I know tomorrow ain't promised. I hope God hears calling. We live and die for the dollar.
We live and die for the dollar.
We live and die for the dollar. We live and die for the dollar.
We live and die for the dollar.
We live and die for the dollar.
Oh, oh, oh. something real, something that you can feel. Okay. Bring back that vibe, y'all. Uh-huh. Out past the Lauryn Hill. Yes, nowadays, everybody got swag. Pull a max out, they gon' mad. Step on they brand new sneakers. Okay. Better run, cause that's your tag. Oops, I mean your buttocks. They'll kill you for them Reeboks. Especially them brand new J's. They praise them ugly high tops. But this ain't about no sneakers. Uh-huh. By the way, I ain't no preacher. I am not of this world. Uh-huh. I am an ugly creature. But God loves ugly, don't he? Uh-huh. Don't think so, you baloney. Come for them dirty ninjas. Matthew 9:13, homie. We're spending poo-poo, don't stink. You're a simp cause you got big bang. Raised up in the house of God. Got dipped in a tank. You full of it like Easter Sunday pulpit. Overzealous lacking knowledge cause you knew in it. But you doing it, but you ruin it. That's right, I said it. Over pursuing it. Don't know what you're talking about. Shut your mouth and put some glue in it. Some say he real with it. Either way, gotta deal with it. Take a pill, cause I'm ill with it. Ain't a thief, but I'm stealing it. Stick killing it. My TV's evil. What happened to these people? Got them waiting outside for the sequel. Yeah, Simon says jump, and the drawer says sure. The tube is full of garbage, but your brain wants more. Dummies are rapping, teeny beanies are clapping. Tell me how did this happen? Corporate fingers are snapping. They think it's beautiful, but ain't suitable. That's my opinion. I think they're evil, and they're trying to turn us to their minions. But I will riot before I go and buy it. My gosh, turn is a tire. These rappers should retire and turn in their pensions and never ever mention they did this for a living, most of all for attention. In a little bit of paper, their moment was a vapor. You're here one day and gone the next. I'm gone, I'll catch you later.
Again, yeah. Shorty say she wet again, yeah. My girl say she wet again, yeah. Yeah, shorty say she wet again.
Try Mr. J, baby.
I don't want for, or she would know. Or she would be standing fan, me fin who ni hoy. I don't want for, or she would know. What's your best standing fun? But wine. Wet again. My girl tell me she wet again. Wet again. My girl tell me she wet again. She say she dey sweat inside the snow. Anytime shorty see me, she wanna get inside the pool. Fear penalty shootout. She wanna take me down the riverbank. If only I promise to dive inside. She open Jerusalem gate. Say make her come inside. Or see me speed in the meter. My spark in the engine. My plug in the heater. I'm gonna be the cause. Wet again. My girl tell me she wet again. Wet again. Wet again. Wet again. Wet again. My girl tell me she wet again. Wet again, wet again. I don't want for or she would know. Or see what a standing fan. Me from who ni who. I don't want for or she would know. Or see what a standing fan. But wine, wine. Wet again, wet again, wet again. My girl tell me she wet again. Wet again, wet again. Wet again, wet again, wet again. My girl tell me she wet again. Wet again, wet again. Wet again, wet again, wet again. My girl tell me she wet again. Wet again, wet again. Wet again, wet again, wet again. My girl tell me she wet again. Wet again, wet again. She wet again, you know. JMJ.
In my conscience, I'm taking no shots with no loss. I'm finding some peace when the meds came. I'm finding some peace when the chairs came. I'm a provider, that's the best thing. I do it for y'all, that's a mad thing. Yeah, yeah, do it for y'all, that's a mad thing. I stay on my job, that's a mad thing. Give it to them hard, that's a mad thing. I stack all these racks, that's a mad thing. I puff on these packs, that's a mad thing. Ain't no going back, that's a mad thing. We all stay in strap, that's a mad thing.
Forced into a situation for obliteration. Stuck us in the projects and started us racing. Casing up the game like we bout to hit a base. Stacking money, cause we have to show them what they really facing. Invest, invest in a motherfucking vest. We about to go to war and it's never gonna rest. I know there's no peace in the streets of America. A land where the dark people stress. Oh yes, it's one of them things. At the time that we hang, I can see all the pain in the eyes of the brain. Infuse my fire like a kerosene blaze. When I learn about your heritage and workers on the slave. Different ancestors did that, then I can do this. Definitely prove this, niggas on his own shit. Taking my heritage, I'm trapped with that metal piece. So your motherfucker better cease and desist. Cover this diamonds with a little wild home. Wing to a diamond by a carpet, five tribes. Have a coke and a smile. If you not with the movement, I bleed for my people every inch, every mile. Fly away, don't like what I say. I'm coming for mine and you all gonna pay. I can see you afraid with a little running yankers and a mule that you promised yesterday.
Okay,
I do this for my people, not equal, we original. Kinda make sense why you motherfuckers copy style. I can break it down like a motherfucking pound. Never round if you really wanna get it right now. I do this for my people, not equal, we original. Kinda make sense why you motherfuckers copy style. I can break it down like a motherfucking pound. I'm around if you really wanna get it right now.
Yeah. When they say more money, more problems, I'm thinking I don't got options. I'm working on facing my conscience. I'm taking no shots with no loss. I'm finding some peace when the meds came. I'm finding some peace when the chains came. I'm a provider, that's the best thing. I do it for y'all, that's a mad thing. Yeah, yeah, do it for y'all, that's a mad thing. I stay on my job, that's a mad thing. Give it to them hard, that's a mad thing. I stack all these racks, that's a mad thing. I puff on these packs, that's a mad thing. Ain't no going back, that's a mad thing. We all stay in strap, that's a mad thing.
I ain't watching treated to kill it, I said it's all. They can't face it like a maker, the best of two damn songs. Call the nigga in the cross, they master with called bumps. Fucking bust up at the job, the cycle is not long. Not to mention prison, not living, they kill you so long. Can you see the plan killing, ain't no people with a call. It's awful, but no one is left staring in awe. We so decent, the top children on kill them all. This world crumbling like Mary Jane. Just to keep my focus clear while I'm driving the left lane. The woods switch lane, but it's so my damn pain. In the past, waiting on the brain is different from the pain. This ain't my only excuse, this is how they made me. This is people in my head and they all hate me. But I'm a soldier, you motherfuckers can't take me. On everything I love is the truth, you can't break me. The souls of my ancestors, this is my spirit. If you hear it, it's enough to make you care what fuckers fear it. My life is like a bus and I'ma be the one to steer it. I'm fighting for my people and everything till we clear it. I'm watching progress and you know we fed up. You really gonna hate us when we get our bread up. Send up black nation, I'm getting impatient. It's time to make the doctor really see the sick patient.
When they say more money, more problems, I'm thinking I don't got an option. I'm working on facing my conscience. I'm taking no shots with no loss. I'm finding some peace when the meds came. I'm finding some peace when the chairs came. I'm a provider, that's the best thing. I do it for y'all, that's a mad thing. Yeah, yeah, do it for y'all, that's a mad thing. I Stay on my child, that's on everything. Give it to them hard, that's on everything. I stack all these racks, that's on everything. I puff on these packs, that's on everything. Ain't no going back, that's on everything. We all staying strapped, that's on everything.
Carry 'em. Yeah, yeah, I'ma go into this. Yeah, yeah, this is Gorilla. Yeah, yeah, I'ma go get the bag. Yeah, yeah, or I'ma get the pad. Yeah, yeah, I'm so cold like, yeah.
Yeah,
I'm so dull like, yeah. We gon' blow like, yeah.
What I'm whipping up,
look how I'm geeking up. I'm so fitted, I'm on Gucci. I'm so pretty,
yeah.
I'm on get it. Watch me move. This is Sally, that's a tool.
Yeah.
On my Kodak,
black.
Ooh, know that.
Yeah.
Ooh, get it.
Yeah.
Hundred bands. Contraband.
Contraband.
I got the plug on who a hawker.
Whoa.
They gonna find you like Baka. Blah.
Ooh, America. I just checked my following. Listen. You motherfuckers owe me.
Everybody, this your boy Mr. E-Boss of the Southside Bosses. You know what it is. This is Revolutionary Hour, where we like to talk about the topics that y'all don't want to talk about, but like my girl Connie just said, y'all always want to listen to. So we're going to go ahead and keep it pushing. Tonight we got Childish Gambino's video with This Is America. We going to be talking about it. And when I say we've got Connie Moore on the line, we got Fallon on the line, and we got your boy Candy Liquor on the line, going hard tonight, where we're going to give our own personal interpretations of how we feel about this video, you know, good or bad. You know, we ain't holding no bars. Ain't that right, everybody?
That's right.
Alrighty. So let's go ahead and introduce everybody first, so everybody know who talking online right now. Who want to introduce themselves first?
My name's Connie Lofton. I'm the CEO owner of Lofton Lofton Records and also recording studio. I own Wah XO Radio, Island Ecstasy, Three Bad Biatches, and a Pitbull.
Already.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Oh, man. Yeah, this your boy. This your boy. CANDYLIQUR. Better known as Candy, looking for Prescription Texas, man. R&B artist, songwriter. Hey, I do a little bit of everything, man. Y'all need that out there, holler at your boy, man.
Hello. Go ahead, Fallon, let them know who you is. Fallon, you still there? Okay, maybe we kind of lost Fallon for a second, but she'll be back on.
Breaking up.
Oh, there you go.
She is.
All right, Fallon, you there? Already. Go ahead and introduce yourself.
Yo, this girl Fallon, a hip-hop lover, founder of Bars Matter, the movement coming soon to you.
Already. Yeah, you know, we have actually a special guest that decided to join us at the last minute. We're going to go ahead and let her introduce herself.
Hey, everybody. It's your host, Star, from FSC, you know, B.O.S.S. Radio. As soon as I heard what we were talking about today, I just had to jump in. So I got here as fast as I could. So sorry I'm late, but I'm here.
We definitely got a good topic tonight. You know, as everybody had a chance to check out the video, This Is America.
Yes.
Alrighty, so we're gonna go around the room real quick. I want to get y'all personal feeling, what y'all personally feel before we actually go through and break down this video and you know, dissect it like a frog. You feel me? But Connor, you want to go ahead and let us know what you feel about the video?
Yeah, I watched it a couple of times. The first time, I'm going to just break it down from the beginning to the end, okay? I was really confused on his body movement, what gender he actually wanted to be. And then as far as, you know, the first situation where the man was shot, I've seen stuff like that already, and then, you know, it goes on and on and on about killing the kids in church and, you know, the whole thing. To sum it all up, basically, is I'm not a big advocate, because we all live in the environment of the schools, you know, with the children, our children, somebody's children, the malls, the churches. I mean, it's everywhere about people getting shot, hurt, or, you know, permanently injured for life, crippled, whatever the situation may be, and my heart goes out to them. But to feel like you should make money off of that, I'm like, really? Because where I moved from, which was Metro East St. Louis, right out of St. Louis, Missouri, to Kentucky 4 years ago, that's why I left there, okay? But I'm not going to be an advocate of, I already know that this stuff goes on, you know, but I'm not going to support it, because it's like, it's kind of like, let me use myself as an example. If one of my children was hurt or shot or killed, why would I want to support your movement and what you're doing? I think you could have found something else a little bit better to do a movie, a film, you know, a video about. We already know this stuff, so what are you showing us that we don't know? I'm not going to never buy it. I don't care a thing about liking it or supporting it in any capacity at all. If nothing else, we should put forth the energy to flip it around to show some good things that do happen in life, instead of always playing off the negative 24/7. You can't give back these families their children and their family, you know, but yet you want to try to push it in our throat like we don't know this goes on. We know it goes on all the time.
Okay.
That's how I feel about it. I didn't like it. I didn't like the choreography about it. I didn't like it at all. I just pretty much felt like it was a smack in my face, like, oh, hey, do you know about this? Well, yeah, I do.
I feel that. Alrighty, anybody, who's next? We got Candy looking. You want to go ahead and tell your personal interpretation of it?
Yeah, I can, you know, pretty much, you know what I mean? I look at it like this. Growing up, like, you know, I grew up in the hood, you know what I mean? Grew up in the hood down here in Corpus Christi, man, and I seen a lot of the things that they talk about in the videos, and just seeing it on live TV and being a father myself, you know what I mean, and having to worry about it every day when my kids going to school if something's going to happen nowadays, you know what I mean? Watching the video kind of gave me a little, you know, gave me a little shocker for a minute because, you know what I mean? But it made me understand some things. You know, the world is a place of reality that things is happening every day. You know what I mean? Like she said, yeah, we see it every day. But this is a way, I guess, some artists use their star power, as we call it, to be able to put something out there, because some people might get it. Some people see it every day like we do, you know what I mean, and understand it. But some people might not understand it, you know what I mean? And so with them using their star power, as you know, at the beginning, the guys shooting. But if you dig deep into some of the movements and some of the way things are broke down in the deal, because the way they portrayed some of the people in the video, because the guy, when he first sits down with the guitar, I'm looking at him and I'm looking like, man, that looks like Trayvon Martin's dad or something, you know? And then I kept looking at it over and over again. And then I started realizing, I guess, is that what he's trying to portray? You know what I mean? And by showing these people and saying certain words about Selly and all this type of stuff, you know what I mean? You know what I mean? About people getting killed. And it's just a lot of deals. But the church thing, when the choir singing, that kind of got me a little bit because, you know, I grew up in the church, you know. I am a vocalist. I sing, you know what I mean? And growing up in the church and seeing the choir and all of a sudden, you know, I understood it was about the church death and everything that's going on, but you know what I mean? But you know, and like she said, a lot of the gender, the way he was moving, a lot of it was a lot of things from the African tribal dances and things, and he was trying to put it in perspective of his own way and his own style. But you know what I mean? But if you're gonna do it right, you know what I mean? And some of the ways, you know what I mean? Some of the stuff he was doing, you can tell it was switched up, you know what I mean? But some of the dances were perfect, but some of them were changed, you know what I mean? Because if you start getting deep, because I can get deep into that era, you know what I mean? About, you know, the African tribes and the Zulu deals and the dances, you know, hey, some of it gets portrayed a little bit away because, you know, that's how it's all supposed to be. They want you to see things a certain way. That's how history is brought out front anyway, you know what I mean? History is a big joke because you don't really know what the deal is. And seeing all this with these videos and stuff nowadays, you really don't know what you're looking at. You don't know what's real or what's reality, but, you know, people getting killed is reality and it is real. And like she said, I feel bad for some of the parents and mothers and daughters and that see that video, and they might feel a little something about it, but some people might see it as bringing an awareness to the reality also. But it can go either way, you know?
Okay. All right.
That's the way I see it.
I feel that too. I feel that. All right, Fallon, what's your personal opinion on it?
Okay, personally, I'm gonna tell you now, I don't like the song, can't stand the song. Personally, I would rather listen to Kanye Scoop-a-dee-doo. But in all fairness, I kind of sort of did like the video versus the song. Still don't like the song. Can't even stand it. I listened to watch it with the goddamn sound off. But I did see some, you know, some things like you said with the African tribe dancing. I saw some of that.
Right, right.
Did anybody notice that the pants he was wearing were Confederate soldier pants?
Yeah, I caught that.
Yeah, I did too.
And then, also, after every killing, I don't think it was so much as the violence, but if you notice, after every killing, the guns are handled with so much care, and the bodies are just like, fuck you. So it's pretty much like that in a society where every time there's a mass shooting, or somebody gets, you know, something goes down, they're putting the blame on the gun versus what about the person?
Right. Exactly.
All these people just lost their lives, but y'all are more focused on his gun.
Exactly.
Don't family take our guns.
Care.
And that's why they need bullet control. Fuck gun control. Start selling bullets at $15,000. I guarantee you we cut it all this down.
You sure right.
I gotta agree with
where
that.
Where I moved from, y'all could get any, just about any kind of handgun you wanted for a gallon of milk. I'm sure it's probably that going rate if I went back home as well.
Wow. No, they won't legally give me one, but I can get one still. Ain't gonna stay.
Well, I'm just saying, it's there. You know what I'm saying? It's there.
Already, I feel that is a good point that video did break up is the gun control problem. Man. But Star, what do you think?
Every video was handed off to somebody in a red cloth. Right. Every gun.
Right now, Star, what's your personal interpretation in video about the video?
Oh, there's just so much. It was so heavy. It was so deep, you know. And I loved it. Like, I loved all of it. I love the video and the song because he literally danced around the issues, which is what we do every day. Yeah, we know that this and that goes on. Yeah, we know and see like the horrific things on the news, and we talk about it for a while. But then the next thing you do is post up, you know, the newest dance craze. Like, that's what the kids are doing. That's what the kids in the video did. They did not pay attention to anything that was happening around them, you know, or in their culture. They didn't pay attention to any of the bad things that are happening. They followed the man that was showing them the dance, that was keeping them distracted. As so many people have said, Jim Crow, that's, you know, what he's portraying is Jim Crow being a distraction to our youth or to our fellow urbanites, and that's what the kids were doing until the very end, when all of a sudden they were put in the situation to where they had to be afraid and run, but they were completely oblivious to it the entire time it was happening all around them. And it's like, oh my God, I don't want to. For some people, say, like, I don't want to see this, or I don't want to watch it, like I know it. And it's like, yeah, but that's what artists do. They put issues in your face and say, hey, look at this. You know, what are we doing about this? Are we just going to continue to just say, yeah, I know? Or are we finally going to talk about it enough until we do something about it and make something happen? So I'm in love with the whole message.
Yeah, now see, me personally, I didn't, when I first heard the song, I didn't know anything about the video, you know. Matter of fact, I heard it just while I was browsing for music to play on the radio station, so I bypassed it instantly, I'm not gonna lie. It wasn't until I heard everybody talking about the song and talking about the video and how the video addresses certain issues that I went and watched the video. By watching the video, it made me appreciate that song more than I did before, because I didn't at all. I didn't like the song. I didn't even want to even keep on listening to the song. I cut it off, I think, halfway through. But watching that video, it's so many things that I've come to see over these 36 years that I've been living. And I try to explain certain things that a lot of people don't actually accept. They don't actually agree with. But watching that video, it proved to me that there's other people that sees exactly what I see. Like, one of the things that nobody talked about when I was watching all the reaction videos and all the videos they were talking about with the breakdowns and stuff like that, the choir, the choir is singing, get your money, black man, get your money, black man, get your money, black man. So now they're throwing in capitalism, and that makes me feel like they know that capitalism is another form of slavery that everybody is a part of. So everybody is slave to the money. So it's saying, get your money. Now you need to be focused on this other slave trade, this other slave system that's existing now to enslave everybody.
The new Jim Crow.
The new Jim Crow. So, and that's like, I heard that, and I had to wonder, why is the choir singing that? Why is they singing that in church? And another thing that came to my attention is something that I've learned is that the church is a multi-million dollar industry. Mm-hmm. No matter how you look at it, the facts remain that the church is a multi-million dollar industry. So, of course, it's going to be the church that's going to be telling you to get your money, because if you're getting your money, you're paying your tithes, and your tithes are paying
them. That's 10%.
Right. So the more money you get, the more money they get.
You're right.
So it's like, when I hear...
You know what's really...
I'm sorry, go ahead.
What? Oh, I was just going to say, I'm sorry, my phone's really cracking up when y'all are talking. I don't know if you're talking or not. It's like a delay thing, so I apologize. The church thing, let me tell you this real quickly. And a really good friend of mine, which is an artist, and it's, we'll just say the state of Arkansas, they were having such a high crime rate about 3 years ago. I mean, you couldn't even walk outside your door. You know, it was just escalating, so horrific. And so he made a comment to me one day. He says, well, you know, I'm going to go to the different churches and see if we can come together and bring the churches as one, first of all, one entity, and see if, you know, with everybody together, that maybe we could do something about this. I said, well, I'm just going to let you know right now, that'll never happen, because they're not going to give up their money to come to another church to be together as one, and maybe a church that doesn't make as much money. So it's all about the mighty dollar. That'll never happen. So he called me back about 2 or 3 weeks later, and he's like, you know what? You're absolutely right. They don't want nothing to do with it. I said,
yeah, because, you know, yeah, because people understand nowadays, if you really look at it, you know, money make the world go round. You know what I mean? And you can't do nothing without an almighty dollar. That's the biggest saying in the world, because it's true. But when you start letting money make you, that's when the game go wrong. You know what I mean? Right. You're supposed to make the money. You make the money and you do what you think, that you do the real thing with the money. You don't turn around and let money make you, and you stand out there and knowing you got what you got, but then you're not doing nothing with it. If you're going to do something with it, do something right. You know what I mean? You know what I mean? Like now, here soon, I got a project I'm finna do with my 8-year-old daughter. You know what I mean? And, you know, she wants to do a song with her dad. So I'm like, all right, come on, let's do this. You know what I mean? Because, you know, I want to show her about this industry and what it's been, what it's all about. If you're going to do music, do real music. Do something you love. Don't just go out here and just do anything. If you're going to participate in something that's right, you know what I mean? Make this music thing right, you know what I mean? And do it right, you know?
That'd be a little yappy.
You know, don't be, you know what I mean? Because you're like, you know, you got these cats hollering, they in the kitchen cooking stuff up like stir fry. Come on now. You know, hey, man, what's
is
the
that
deal?
What that song say?
You know, hey, sure.
Is that what that
we
song
know
say?
What the game is?
Oh Lord!
You know
like
I mean? Hey, man.
If they in the kitchen cooking
they
up stuff like stir fry, they ain't got no clientele.
You don't hold on. Wait a minute! I don't see the 8-year-old. I don't see the 8-year-old paying rent before. Don't do that. Don't do that.
Yeah.
He's paying rent. So I got that work. What you mean you got that work? You mean you got school work?
Right.
No, I got that work.
I got that
word. I still have to say
that. I don't know if I want to rob you or whoop you right now.
Exactly. That's the way it is.
Your children and your life and your generations, it still starts from home.
Yes.
I mean, seriously, it still starts from home. The children that are running around in the streets these days will cuss you worse than a damn sailor, and the mother will stand there and say, oh, come on, honey, let's go. Let me get you that candy bar. I will take that damn candy bar, beat the shit out of you with it, is what I'm going to do.
And then let you watch
you
the
show.
That's
right.
What I'm going to do.
These kids now, they got too much
don't
attitude. Too
but,
much attitude, I believe and no common sense.
But then again, even though the video shows, you know, the children aren't conscious of their surroundings and blah, 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 I can guarantee you mine are very conscious of their surroundings, that they're not even in my job field.
Right, see,
they're
that's...
They're real, and they're...
Right, now that's why I feel like that you got a point there. And I don't think that is saying more of they're not being conscious to what's going on. I think what they're saying is that we've been dehumanized to the point where we see it and we think that's normal life. We just keep on dancing.
That's why. Because here's the thing. If you constantly look, and just so y'all know, I don't read the newspaper and I don't watch the news. Quit doing that probably about 10 years ago.
Right.
Okay? Mm-hmm. I completely removed myself from it.
Even pressure.
And that's why a good friend of mine told me about that. I was like, really? And I was like, yeah, okay, well, I'm just going to remove myself from it. And actually, it's a beautiful thing because you just hear things like we're talking tonight. But
exactly.
when you watch this video, it gets you comfortable with watching somebody get shot in the head with a gun. You get comfortable. Now, I'm not telling you watching it on a video is just as comfortable as watching it in true life, but you get my point here. You have to step up to the plate and say, I don't want this to be an everyday thing, walk down the street, you know, I carry a 9mm with 17 mag, you know, loaded in it. I mean, but the point of it is I don't want my family to get comfortable with that. Because it's not a comfortable thing.
Right.
Yeah, but in the video, I think Childish Gambino was kind of pointing out that, yeah, personally, individually, in our homes, and with our families, and with our children, no, of course we don't want to be comfortable with that, you know? But I think those are the people that he's really calling out to, because it's entitled, This is America. We have become, as a nation, comfortable with these things happening, because like we said, they happen all the time, and people are arguing about, you know, whatever and this and that, instead of like arguing about the guns and things like that, instead of saying, okay, but what are we going to do? Why are we so okay with the fact that this happens as a whole? You know, I might not like it as an individual, I might not want to see it like right in my face, but the kids, like, they are now. Now kids are hearing things that are happening, and they're just used to it. Like, now anybody born after 2000, well, not anybody born after 2000, but anybody born before the year 2000 is now an adult. And these are the things that they're okay with. These are the people that we are going to have to live life with.
Let me ask you this question, and it's just strictly, strictly off the cuff here, okay? Where does we come in the world today? Where does the word we work? Now, Eric and I are we. We work together. We're friends. We talk.
Right.
We are a we. But you have too many people out here. And Eric knows, and I apologize, I'm not trying to offend anybody with this statement or where I'm going with this, but here's the thing. I have we in my life of all races, okay? I know people that don't have a we because they're only stuck with a particular race.
Right.
Because they don't look at people the way I look at people. I'm a white person. Who cares, you know? But still, at the end of the day, like, I'm the only one out of all the kids that my mom says she doesn't see color, because I don't. I don't give a rat's ass who you are, how much money you make, where you live. I'm like a chameleon. I can sit in the hood, and I can sit up there and eat dinner with Trump. It doesn't make any difference at the end of the day. But the point of it is, there is no we in anything anymore. Very rarely do you hear, we are going to get together and we're going to see what we can do to unite as one, as a team, a family, to change this.
Exactly.
There is no we.
I can relate to that, you know what I mean? And you, hey, G baby, you already know E. You know me, man. Shoot, I'm a 6'4", 305 black man. Hey, my wife is a 5'7", little short white girl. Love her to death.
I'm gonna get her a ladder.
Been married 12 years. I got three little beautiful half breed babies running around. You know what I mean? I got my half-breed babies running around. They growing up in the world that they don't know nothing about. Dad done seen things that they don't know nothing about, and they ain't gonna right. never get to see. You know what I right. mean? And I can understand and relate to that. You know what I mean? But that's the whole problem of the world is it shouldn't be anything about color, because people are gonna be people regardless. You know what I mean?
Right.
When it comes down to somebody killing somebody, it shouldn't be about color, because what? What are you going to... Yeah, what? Oh, a color killed that person? No, that gun killed that person. You know what I mean? Mindset. You know, because they put that gun in that person's hand. It's you know what I mean?
We as people need to make a we.
Exactly.
It's not you and I against the world. It's us together. So once you get the people together to understand what we're saying, we're not really disagreeing, we're agreeing. We need to go out there and clean our own porch off before I start cleaning Fallon's porch off.
Yeah.
You got to clean up at home before you can go out in the street and clean up there.
Now,
so if your child is going to come at me acting stupid, rolling their eyes, well, I hope you catch your brain back in the back of your head as far as I'm concerned, because I can roll my eyes and rubberneck you right back. But still, at the end of the day, that's disrespectful. If I come to you as a parent, or this guy's got a video that he wants to put out, and your child's acting a damn fool, and I'd come to you as a parent or an adult and say, look, you know, I find that disrespectful, then respect me. Because I'm telling you that's offensive to me. I'm not tripping off on your child, because you don't want me to trip on your child and you both. But at the end of the day, be mindful of the people that you're with and their feelings. I need to respect feelings the same as people need to respect mine. You don't have to like them, but you should respect them. And we have lost, as a whole world, we have lost the true meaning of respect. This video, I don't find it respectful. I find it offensive, and I truly respect everyone's opinion for how they feel about it, but I don't need to teach this. It's been taught. It's been seen. It's lived. So I would rather take that and flip it around to something better. That's my whole thing about it. I want to make this a better situation.
What they need to do is play that video in reverse. And it'd probably be a lot better.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah, reverse it.
That video. Reverse that video of people getting shot in the head. Reverse that video of the people getting killed in the church. Reverse that. But you can't reverse reality. You know what I mean? That's one thing people have to understand. We can't reverse reality. So reality is done. And that's what we need to leave it. Let it be done. Don't bring it up to the, families might watch that video and get upset.
Now, this is the reason why I got to disagree with leaving it at that, because that's what we tend to do, and that's exactly what the video is saying, that we tend to leave it at that. All this horrific stuff is happening again. We're not going forward. We're not making any progress. And that's what the ending of it.
Wait.
Let me finish. All right, but you got at the end where he's standing on top of the old model cars. All of those are old model cars, and they're just standing stagnant. They're not going anywhere. And that's exactly what he's saying, is that there's no progress being made. We keep saying this stuff, and we keep saying just to leave it alone. But people keep dying.
Did you see the Yugo? Huh? Did you see the Honda Accord?
Yeah, all those old model cars.
I'm gay.
You know who
the Yugo represents, right?
Nah, who that?
Who's the first man they got beat on the freeway?
Oh, Rodney King.
Rodney King.
Exactly. Yeah. Honda Accord. Wife and daughter sitting there in the car. Husband gets shot.
Right.
Blue Honda Accord. See, you gotta pay attention to it. It's a message to a bunch of
that, and because of that footage, and because nobody let it go, he got justice for that.
Yeah, those weren't the first. They were just, you know, they were recorded and they were publicized.
Right.
And, you know, because at that point, black people had known for years
that
there was police brutality. And we had been saying something, but nobody did anything about it, until this video of a black man being beat on the freeway was put in everybody's face. Everybody didn't like it, but we didn't either while it was going on. And then, you know, you also look at something else that happened that I meant to mention in the video, is the white horse with death riding on it, which is mentioned in the book of Revelation
of
the Bible.
And in the book of Revelations, in the Bible,
And that's saying that hell is following, with hell will follow that pale horse. And in the video, what's following is
the police car.
Yeah, now, with that, it's saying, okay, so we don't want to talk about this situation, we don't want to see it, we're just going to let it ride, but you saw that horse coming. You know, you see what's happening. And sometimes I think maybe it does need to be really pushed down some people's throat or everybody's throat and say, hey, everybody get real uncomfortable, because there are a few people who are made uncomfortable every single day, and that needs to change. Somehow there are parents, good parents out there. Yes, it seems like children are getting worse. It's not seems like children are getting worse, you know, and there are good parents out there. You know, they're teaching at home and that are doing the home thing. But what we also need to start building is a community. Like, because said, that's where we lost the respect at. We lost the community, and so we lost respect for our neighbor. Right. You can build in your home. Yes, you can start at home. But if you can't tell your child, and once you walk out this door, you be the person I taught you to be here, then it's all lost, because they get around their friends, and then all of a sudden, there's somebody else.
That's a peer pressure.
Yeah,
that's the peer pressure. But let me ask you that. Let me ask you all this: do you think there aren't people taking this video and saying, "Oh yeah, they're condoning, they're thinking it's okay to do this," because they may not have the mental capacity to truly understand the message that the guy's giving out?
Every piece of propaganda could be spun in any kind of way. But I think that's what he was wanting, is letting everybody. Leaving it for everybody's interpretation, and that's why we're having a dialogue, is everybody has their own, they see different things, when they see the same thing, but they got a different viewpoint on it. And I think that's actually a good deal, because it brings up more issues. It shows us what's lying up underneath the skin.
Mm-hmm. Definitely.
Yeah. I mean, to me, you know, I can only go by things that I feel is right, you know,
right.
But I know that in my lifetime, I have fed people. I've let people live in my home I didn't even know, because they didn't have a place to sleep. I have busted my ass for people. I couldn't even tell you what their phone number is or their last name.
Right.
But at the end of the day, it didn't make any difference. They were all racist. They were all, but there was no disrespect. There was none of this, oh, hey, you know, I'm going to come do this to you, and I'm going to just walk down and bang you, you know, and do all that. That has to change, and the only way it's going to change, if all of us understand one thing, we're all brothers and sisters at the end of the day. It don't make no difference who your mama, who your daddy is, where you was born. I know my family's from, I'm French and German. I'm as fair-skinned blonde as you could possibly want, like the driven snow out here at the end of the day. But it doesn't mean that you're still not my family and that I don't care for you. I care for you because you're a human being.
And, you know, I agree with you 100% on that. Yeah. It's just, you know, some family members don't get along.
Well, no, some of my blood family and I, we don't get along at all.
Hey, that's just flat out reality right there.
I feel the same,
I got more family that ain't blood than I do that is blood.
Right.
I think a lot of people do now. And I grew up in I grew up going to a predominantly white school, myself being black. And I never, you know, I've never seen white people as the enemy. I actually moved in high school and went to a more urban school. So people always said, oh, you talk like a white girl. That is not offensive to me or anything.
You're real
you know, but, yeah. Like, I've lived on
a two really different sides. Really, how do they talk?
You know, yeah, I've lived on two different sides. You know, I've lived on the white side of town, and you know, in suburbs or whatever you want to call it, and then I've also lived in hoods before, and so I'm a people person. I don't have a problem with people or anything like that, but even though I love everybody, something that also happened to me at this white school when I was in the seventh grade is that someone hung a noose in my locker. Now
somebody what?
A noose. Someone hung a noose in the year 2000 in my locker for me to find. And you would think, oh, things like that don't happen. Or, well, not that they don't happen, but you would think that it shouldn't be things that should happen in the new millennia, but they do. And, you know, my parents had to sit down and really talk to me and tell me, hey, there are going to be people that, and it's not the race, there are going to be people that have poor mindsets, who aren't going to understand who you are only going to look at you as an object. And, you know, you have to understand that you can't let that affect you, you know, and the person that you want to be or the person that you want to belong.
And it's a lot harder to say, it's easier to say than to do.
It is. It really is.
Yeah.
But that's why I say it doesn't have to be a race thing, but it is a mindset. And sometimes we know that you can't, it's really hard to change a person's mind, you know, or change their heart.
So we need to change the mindset.
But when you put it out there and you find out and you start hearing the stories, you know, of all races, and somebody comes to you and says, oh yeah, hey, my white or my Latino sisters, I love y'all, but hey, this is something that I went through in my personal experience, then that's
Is it necessary to classify the lady as Latino?
No, I'm saying, like, if you personally, like, me being black, if I go to my white or Latino friends and, you know, tell them of the stories that I've gone through because I'm black, like, they've told me things that they've gone through because of their race. It wasn't, we're not saying, oh, hey, this is just a race issue, but the thing that happened was because of the color of my skin. You know, that noose wasn't hung in my locker because I was a female. It wasn't hung in my locker because I was a girl, you know, or a human being, or anything like that. It was done because of the color of my skin. So, it is an issue, and it does have to be caught up. You know, we shouldn't just talk about, like, oh, well, it's just a race thing. But sometimes it does boil down to, okay, well, we need to open people's eyes to the fact that things do happen just because of the color of a person's skin, you know.
Well, it's not any different than Caucasian or white females. If they have a male friend that's, say, a black guy, then all of a sudden she's the N-word lover. You know what I'm saying?
Oh, yeah.
And all of that, because they are so simple-minded that they don't understand that, you know, it doesn't make any difference what the color of the person is. It's about the person.
You know what I mean?
Yeah, so
I understand, y'all. Because growing up in South Texas, I grew up down here in South Texas, man. I didn't see it and heard it all, you know? So it's a little bit of everything down this way, you know? And then plus the line, like you said, the line of work I do also, you know what I mean? I'm in the security field, you know what I mean? I've been in the security field now for probably about 10 years or more. And, you know, and I work with one of the largest security companies in the world, you know? And I go through it all, you know what I mean? I've been called boy. I've been called the N-word.
Yeah.
I've been called every word in the dictionary. But, you know, sometimes you just don't let it get up underneath your skin because you know who you are, you know what I mean?
Right.
And you just try to keep going, you know. And it's like you said, you know, with the video and all, this cat is just trying to show people his way. You know what I mean? That's what I think it's all about. He's just trying to give some information out to the people who don't pay attention.
Right. Now, on that note, let me ask you a question.
Who doesn't pay attention would be my question. Who doesn't pay attention? They talk about it everywhere, all over the place.
Well, it is a lot of people that I talk to at work, at my job personally, that they don't have, like, any conversation about it. Like, this is the type of stuff that I talk about at work, and I am the only one that talks about it at work. I am the only one that have conversations with themselves at work, apparently, because don't nobody else have anything to say about anything that I have to say about the topics that are going on in the world. They're too busy worried about what they're doing tonight or what they did last night or who they did last night. So yeah, that's kind of the dance scene. Yeah, that's kind of the dance scene that goes on whenever they dance around the conversations that I be trying to have. Because I am a type of person that, you know me, Connie, and Fallon, y'all grew up, you went to school with me. So, you know, I like to talk about controversial things because those are the things that need to be addressed so that they don't have to exist no more. If I don't have to talk about them, that's when we should be feeling comfortable.
Yeah. See, I hit on my issue. I grew up all over because I was an Army brat. I grew up in Germany. They love us over there.
Right.
I was until I came over to the United States that I was ever called a nigger. And that was at 8 years old.
Yes.
Luckily, I had a mother that was a Black Panther leader of her division. She taught me and raised me and didn't know she was going to get this little militant Black bitch coming along. But that's what she got. They done already labeled me. They looking at me. They watching and everything. I got videos. They watching. But my issue is that he's not showing nothing hasn't been going on for over 400 years.
Right. That's what I'm saying.
Over 400 years, we are still slaves. And it ain't just Black people now that are slaves. It's everybody.
Uh-huh. You sure
so we choose, that's what Wayne said. We choosing to be slaves. Slavery's a choice. People got mad. But now they ain't. What's mad about? You still choosing to live in your fear. You still choosing to do what you know is wrong. And you still choosing, are we just going to talk about it? When the fuck is y'all going to stop talking about it and do something about it?
Right.
Exactly.
We've been talking for over how many years? We've been talking since Martin Luther King, Huey. Talking has got to stop somewhere down the line and change has got to happen.
Right.
Yep.
Yeah.
We got to stop being them old model cars and we got to start upgrading like we upgrade our cars in real life. Some people get a new car every year, but they still have that same mindset. So it's like that's the same car. That's all I think it all boils down to right now. I think everybody can agree on that. In order to be able to make some changes, everybody got to change their mindset. We all got to make changes.
Everybody got to be on one accord. You know what I mean?
Stop
trying to be a chief and just join the Indian band and everybody go.
But here go the issue that I feel. We are going to come together as one people until black Americans can learn how to come together as one.
Right.
Yes.
We can't even try to get along with anybody else if we can't get along within ourselves.
Home front. Definitely.
Exactly. Definitely. Got to get our own straight. Everybody else is straight. They stick together.
Right.
Mm-hmm. No matter what.
Exactly.
I can't say that I really agree with that because in predominantly in my race, there's always all kinds of issues. I mean, there is.
Now, with that being said,
Black African Americans are the only ones that do not know their own history. They do not know their own people. They don't know nothing.
They don't want to learn.
Well, what do we know about ours?
Connie, you can actually do a y'all can do a lineage check and find out exactly what country
you're
from.
Yeah, we can't go back no further than the slave master that owned us.
Right.
That's as far as back as we can go.
And we get that by last name.
So we are a lost nation, really.
But my point in saying that is I can only go so far with mine because my family wasn't from this country. I was born here, but 8 generations ago, my family came over from out of the United States.
Right, and it's still easier for you to check your lineage than it is for us to check our lineage outside of this country.
Yeah, they even told us that. So how many
generations can you go back?
I can go back to, I can only go back to a plantation. That's it. It stops at a plantation.
Here. Even they said that with the DNA test that they have out to where you can find out exactly where you came from, they're able to do that more for other races and say, hey, you're 17% this, and this is exactly around the area of that country that you came from.
But we're mixed with like every tribe of Africa almost now up to this point, so we don't know where we got African, we got European, we got some of everything now in our blood, so we really don't know. We're like a lost child that don't know where we belong.
Yeah, with African Americans,
people tell us Africa don't.
Because
I understand what you're saying. I understand. There's no true placement of
putting your feet somewhere and saying,
"Yeah, all they can tell us is that we're from the sub-Saharan of Africa." But like, it's like, okay, so we know that, but that's all they can say for all Black Americans is somewhere in sub-Saharan Africa. Like, we knew that part.
Nah, let's think of this on a subconscious level as well. Now, whenever we was being raised and we're being taught in school, for the most part, Black history starts not in Africa but in slavery. So we're taught our heritage starts in as slaves, that we was dominated, that we was working for us, and that's all we was ever good for. So that puts at a young age, that puts some. That, well, I don't know if y'all ever heard of epigenetics. Pretty much, you inherit the pain and scars of your ancestors. Mm-hmm. That's all we know.
Exactly.
If now, we don't know anything, I do kind of
believe. Yeah, we don't.
I believe that's encoded in DNA.
Right.
Yeah.
So if you don't know where you came from before slavery, all you know is you are a slave. That's the only thing you can ever. You can hear all day long that the slaves was free, but all you know is that you was created to be a slave. That's the only thing that's going
to happen. Especially if you were born here, that's what you were meant to do and be here.
So you already have a devalued sense of life. Hence why you have all these kids that don't care. And they get worse because they feel like it's not going to get any better.
And to top it off,
that kind of parents that will teach. No, we did. We started as kings and queens and all scholars. They don't tell you that.
Yeah, and to top it
off, everybody has that privilege learning.
Yeah, when you learn in school that this is what, you know, our families and our ancestors were brought here to do, and that's what essentially we were supposed to be once, you know, our generations came along. Something else that you figure out, you know, without really knowing, is that we didn't win, we didn't win our freedom. Like, children don't really just think about it, but it is taught to you that it was given to us. We didn't win it back. We didn't take it back. It was given to us.
A white man gave us our freedom.
Yeah, you know, and so you kind of feel like,
you weren't given your freedom. You were given the illusion of freedom until you chose to act like
it. Because when you go to war and you fight for your freedom, then and you win it, you can say, okay, these are the things that I want to come along with my freedom. But when it's given to you, then you're still told this is what you are now. You go from being told that you're a slave to being told, okay, well, you're free, but you're also an American, or you're also, so these are now the laws that you have to abide by, or these are the things that you have to do in order to be free and to keep your freedom. Because that, you know, just goes on to the booming prison industry and all that stuff too. But, you know, just saying, like, we need to win. We need to fight. We do need to fight back. And it's not now, like we were saying earlier, it's not just Black people, it's everybody. We all need to fight the fight and win our true freedom from the oppressions that are happening, instead of dancing around the issues like we all have been for so long. And it is going to start with some respect, and it is going to start with building the communities back, you know, in-house, of course. And when I say in-house, I don't just mean in your home individually. I mean in-house with your race, because it is also true that, you know, people are identified better with people who look like them, you know. So build as with your races, and build with people who also don't look like you, you know, your neighbors. So a lot of things are going to have to happen, and I'm glad it's a conversation, but like you said, it's going to have to escalate past the conversation. We've stopped marching, you know, but if...
Well, you know, Eric and I had a conversation a few years ago about the slavery thing, because he was posting some things, and I went on Facebook, and I said, you know, those kind of bother me, and let me tell you why. And he said, what? I said, do you know that the white race was 100 years, not 30, but 100 years into slavery prior, where the black race owned our race? We were slaves to them, and then it flipped. But most people do not dig deeper into certain types of situations. Now, why did the Caucasian race choose not to
or change it up or whatever they did that they didn't do with the other races, I have no idea. But it isn't something we talk about. It's something we know, it's in the past, but we choose to implement what we want to do and we move forward. We don't always have our own army with us, but I guess it depends on how you're raised, you know, individually raised. Because some people really, you know, may still talk about, well, you know, we were slaves to them before, you know, they were slaves to us and all that sort of stuff, but you never hear that part of conversation. So Eric and I, after having that brief conversation, remember that, Eric?
Yeah, I remember that. Yeah, I think I still got it
then
on YouTube.
Then he was like, really? Yeah, well, I but they don't teach that
about
a whole
the,
lot.
I knew about the European slaves. I knew about that. What the realization was that when the slaves, whenever it flipped, the actual way that it flipped, and the miseducation that's going on in school, and because if you want, we have to look at where we get.
Yeah,
our
but I am considered a European slave because I'm German and French. You see what I'm saying? I am European. My ancestry is European slave.
Okay.
So they chose. They were farmers. They chose to come to the United States, and they did. They didn't
right.
have slaves in the true sense we understand it, but they had people that lived. And my great grandmother. I mean, I remember her even doing it. We had men that came and they sat at the table and ate with us. We didn't know them from a can of paint, but they helped us with the cattle and. You know, different things like that, but that's just how they repeated those habits. You see what I'm saying?
And see, that's
from
what—that's exactly
what
why
she got from hers.
That's exactly why I push that nationality is very important, because when we say to white people, you know, I actually got to talk to somebody the other day about it, because they were talking about white women marry in for money and wealth, and I'm just thinking about my homeboy Charles over here, and I'm just thinking about my godbrother Dub. Who are married to white women, and they make the same amount of money as each other. It ain't got nothing to do with money. It was all about love.
Exactly.
You know, so I actually approached them about that.
She was living when I didn't have nothing.
Right, it's not. It wasn't white people that did what they did, but it was the nationalities of the English, the Spanish, that actually encumbered slavery over here on this land. And it's the ancient.
Right.
Now, I ain't gonna say ancient. But the Middle Ages, English and Spanish. And the only thing that we're trying to bring to acknowledgement now is just like, well, let's say Wells Fargo. A lot of people don't know Wells Fargo. Before it was Wells Fargo, it was, I believe, Wachovia. Yeah, it was Wachovia. And before that, it was called something else.
Yeah,
and
Wachovia.
Name, during that time,
yeah.
They was the main financiers of slavery. That means that this bank, three generations down the line, that's still making money off of us, financed slavery and never issued an apology. Never did anything to make up for the fact that they financed slaves, that they financed the slave ships, that they financed the auctions. You know, and they are still.
I don't want
benefiting.
No goddamn apology. I want my money. Shoot, I still ain't seen the receipts of what y'all bought us with. We were dripped up and draped out. What did you buy us with, sir? And what ships did you bring us on? I'm not understanding this. I need to see receipts.
Right.
I
and
need
see,
a refund. Give me no pilot. Give me my cash.
That's another thing. It's a lot of things in history that does not add up.
It was
and
all
I think
in the trade.
The reason
in
why,
the trade.
Right. And I think the reason why these things don't add up in history is because of the fact they want to race bait you. They want to get you involved in the race war. Just like, okay, Fallon, you remember back in Westlake how we had, during Black History Month, what movie did they make us watch?
Amistad.
Amistad.
I was going to say, please don't say Amistad.
How was we after we watched Amistad? How was the whole class after we watched?
We
was out for
everybody,
murder.
Put it like this. Now, we had a predominantly Black school and all our teachers are white. Every white teacher was on edge for that whole week.
Yes.
You better not say shit.
Right.
You better you go to the who office? I ain't going nowhere.
And it was the administration that had us watch them without putting it in proper context. Without actually showing us or telling us what happened to those slave ships, what happened to those logs that they say all of they have of all every African that came from the west coast of Africa. Why don't they have all these things readily available at a museum for us to see? They have slave museums, but they
I'm still waiting for the ship.
Yes, right, exactly.
On one ship.
Exactly. What happened to the wood?
Just
the
take for instance what we're talking about now. They play so much about race against race, just like you said, Eric. But how much do you see when a white officer, which we had this situation, a white officer had a lady with two children, she was in trouble for child endangerment. The white officer did not give her a ticket. He took her and bought her two baby car seats. Now, you don't hear about that because, see, that's beautiful and lovely.
Oh, yeah, I remember that one.
Hey, you know, that's why I came up with the saying, for every good cop, he needs to go be a sheriff because he'll have a little bit more power. If we have good cops and more power, then maybe this whole fiasco with the cop industry would come to an end. But what it is that we have these good cops that...
But that's what I'm trying to tell you.
Yeah, they're not...
They're always going to tell you more about the bad. They play on it more and harder than they are the good. Because they don't want anybody to get along. They want us all not to like each other.
Right.
Because then they've got you.
Yeah, because if we come together,
they got you.
You're
the puppet.
And if we make these problems,
pretty much they already want to keep it over under 400,000 people.
Yeah, because
so you doing this population control for them?
Yeah, because if we come together as a people and we start saying, "Oh, that's a good thing. I'm gonna go do something nice now," or you know. Like, if we pass it along, these good things that are happening, then all of a sudden we start to stop thinking about, oh, what am I going to do to get back at this person that I don't like or that doesn't look like me, or this fear that we have of other people. And then we're going to start looking at the people who are in power, the people who are in control, and start paying attention to them because we have, you know, freer space in our minds and be like, hey, wait a minute, you're doing what now? You know... If we start paying attention to them
here where I live, you can be in a restaurant and people actually come up and pay your bill and you don't know until it's time to pay your bill. They actually do that here.
Oh, wow.
There's people that'll pay for your groceries and you're in line. They don't know whether you really got the money. They ain't ear hustling to find out you're struggling. They just say, well, your bill's paid for.
They sure ain't doing that in Atlanta.
No. Atlanta's supposed to be home of the Southern hospitality, ain't there? Atlanta's supposed to be the home of the Southern hospitality, but you would not see that.
You better not be short.
But I mean,
it's survival of the fittest out here.
Yeah, I mean, they can change and it can be different. You just have to formulate it and do it. Can everybody afford to? No. But that don't mean you can't give little Joey some bubble gum. You know, I mean, whatever. You know what I'm saying? It's got to start somewhere.
Right. It does.
I can't be going and buying everybody's groceries every week. And it doesn't make any difference. It's a very mixed area here because of the military bases. So you already know.
And see, that's the thing. You know, as an individual shouldn't have to go out and buy everybody groceries when we have all these big churches that are collecting everybody's money.
Right. No, I'm not saying they should. They just do it.
No, I understand. I understand what you're saying. But it's just a lot that. So one thing I actually did want to see if y'all noticed. Where did Childish Gambino get that gun, that first gun from? Because they show us with his back turned, and he doesn't have a gun anywhere.
They pulled it out of his. He really don't. Was it in his pocket?
He did. Them tight ass competitive pants. Them pants were so damn tight, he made me look like a young thug around this bitch.
No, it was one of those shocking things that.
You mean Jeffrey? We are not going to call him no thug. Jeffrey. But you will address him as such.
But you did see
how. I'm calling no man in a dress no thug. Jeffrey.
But you did see how the dress was taken out of the scene.
It's the way those pants were made, too. They had a high back, so you really couldn't see it. It was pretty much tucked in, so he like reached in his back of his pants.
Gave a whole new meaning to pulling it out your ass, you know.
He probably looked like he wanted to pull some out of his pants on the get go, but I'm like going, don't scare me.
That's the fact that the matter that I think it was, like I said, personally. It's something that got to be talked about. I mean, with the guns and red cloth being handled with care before the victim even hits the ground, That's something that I've been seeing all my life.
Oh, the victims were dragged away.
They were dragged away. That was something, and we see that. I think that's the symbolism for whenever somebody gets killed by at least like police, they let them. They don't try to save their life. I know it's not protocol, but it is human to try to want to save somebody who's losing their life, and you never see that.
Oh, and this is kind of something else, but like with Orange is the New Black, I was watching, I think it was last season, where they tried to do one of the things where they had been talking about, you know, a person of authority killing a minority or something by doing, and they were on top of a really small girl, you know, so she was saying, "I can't breathe," you know, to kind of symbolize the whole Eric Garner thing and all that. And then after she had died, for the next episode, they left her body there for like 2 days, which is something that they did with Sandra Bland, and she died in the jail. So, well, what they say. So, you know, how are you in power and you are like just literally disrespecting being very inhumane to the dead whom you killed, but as a service to the community, which is how you're trying to spin it, for, you know, saying that, oh, we did this for you, but, you know, then you're so disrespectful to the body. But then when guns come up, we handle them with care, and we're like, no, those are precious things that we should keep, you know, and that we should keep safe and make sure that people are allowed to have them. And I do believe that people should have the right to bear arms, but I also believe that...
Bullet control, coach.
Yeah, but I also believe that, you know, we should handle people with care as well, and instead of how things have been handled with so many people, so many times they have been in the hands of law enforcement.
Right.
Like, not just before their death, but after their death.
You can rebuild a gun. You can break a gun down and put it back together. You can't break a life down and put it back together. You know what I mean? You can't break a life down and put it back together. You know what I mean? Once that life is gone, that life is gone.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? That's the whole object of it all. Life should be more precious than a gun, because life is you know what I mean? You only get one shot at life. You know what I mean? You get one shot. You get one shot at life, a gun comes around and goes around. You know what I mean? Just like money. You know what I mean? But once your life is gone, you can't take nothing with you, because you came in with nothing. You know what I mean? So you got to be realistic about it. And that's why the society and the world to this day is not being realistic anymore. They're not realistic anymore. Everything is what they portray it and want it to be. It's all a big movie. It's all a video. You know what I mean? That's what it is. You know what I mean? That's what life is being portrayed as, a video and a movie now. You know what I mean?
Oh, yeah.
It's not real. It's not real anymore.
Yeah, with that,
the only way you make it real is if you keep it real, well, keep it 100 all the time. You know what I mean? That's the way I am. I'm 100 all the time.
Right, now that brings up a good point about the children when they was dancing with Childish Gambino. Like, a lot of people say that symbolism for these artists are keeping us entertained and keeping us distracted. What do you think we can do as parents to keep that from happening?
To me, the video when the kids dancing, that was more of a way of a distraction.
Right.
You know what I mean? That was a distraction error. You know, so for you not to pay attention to what's really going on. They're telling you to put your blinders on. Don't pay attention to the background. Just pay attention to me dancing. Right. You know what I mean?
So what would you tell
don't
your
really
child?
Need to see what's going on.
What would you tell
that was
your
his point of saying what... That's what the news do every day.
Yeah.
You know, the news do that every day. The news put out so much, because I had a homeboy down here in Corpus. I don't know if y'all heard about it. It was a husband and wife that got killed in their home. And this husband and wife, you know what I mean, they get killed in their home. But what does the news do? Oh, they bring up their past history of them being in trouble with the law. and putting their mugshots on TV after they get killed. What kind of shit is that?
Right.
You know, why come you didn't...
And it's not even relevant.
You know what I mean?
Well, it's the same. And like, then after
you
didn't
portray them as what you wanted to portray them, and then you want to come back, oh, they were model citizens, and they were a loving husband and wife, but you already put them down.
Right.
Yeah. You know what I mean? That's what the world comes to.
People. You know, you'll notice that when something happens or children of a certain race can literally kill someone or go out, like, intentionally kill someone, and all of a sudden it's, the child, you know, this child was in football and he was doing this, but they make sure they say he's a child, they don't show his face, and usually the boy is like 17 years old or something. But then, a lot of times when it's black or Latino children, they can be actual children, and they'll say, oh, well, four thugs ran and did this, when two or three of those kids were probably just in the car. You know, they were in a bad situation. They just post their face all over the news, and it's like, you're not even supposed to do that. But once it's done, it's done. And, one of my cousins, actually, I was really little when it happened, but I had a cousin who was arrested when he was 16, about a week before his 17th birthday, in Corpus, and he was riding with some people who robbed a store. Now, when he was arrested, he actually cried about it. You know, he asked if they could call his mom and all that. You know, he wanted to go home. He was a kid. And instead, what the cop decided to do was put him in the holding cell with other inmates. So what happened was those inmates actually killed my cousin. They thought that because he was scared and because he asked the cops, can you call my mom because I want to go home, that he was going to, you know, be a snitch. So they killed him. And he wasn't even supposed to be in there in the first place. But he was tried as an adult and basically convicted to death before he ever stood trial because somebody decided that he was already an enemy of the state. And so that's what we need to change minds, you know, so that things like that will stop happening. And that was what, the early 90s in Corpus Christi. So, the things like that, like the media knows what it's doing.
Oh, yeah. They know
what it's doing.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's been lovely, but I'm on a totally different time zone than you all are.
Yeah.
Eric, appreciate you as always, and I got to get up and go play with the inmates tomorrow. So,
I appreciate you coming on and talking to us tonight.
Thank you, honey.
Yeah, but you're welcome, Fallon. Eric can tell you how to get a hold of me, and much love to everybody. Be safe, okay?
Yeah. Well, you too. Safe now.
Peace.
Bye. Good night.
Yeah, that's actually a very interesting video, to say the least. You know, this video has actually opened up a lot of people's mouths about everything, you know. And I love the fact that everybody got a different viewpoint on it, because it makes you see everybody's viewpoint. If you got an open mind, you can actually break down the video, you know, even if you don't like the video or the song. You can break it down and be able to get certain meanings out of it.
That's what makes it art.
Right. So, I think that's...
Exactly.
Like I said, I like the song, but if there's people who can do a better job out there, y'all listening right now, we actually give y'all a challenge to come up with your own artistic view of America. And what y'all think about that? Y'all think that's a good idea?
Yeah.
Yeah, that sounds like something good. That's a challenge.
That actually get people, you know, to talk about it, and you never know, we'll probably have a Grammy Award winning video come to us, you know. So then we're gonna actually put that challenge out there. So if y'all listening right now, y'all make sure y'all check us out on Facebook. We're gonna put that challenge out there. Make your own This Is America video and see what people feel about your video. What y'all think about that?
I suggest they do a whole song.
Okay, because I need bars.
Right.
Because them bars suck. Sorry. They did.
And see, that's the reason why I didn't
I liked the school video, too. I'm jamming on that.
Yeah, but that's the reason why I didn't like it at first, because I just heard the song. I didn't really see the video. And I think what I like more about it is what's going on in the video, more than the song. So maybe we get somebody who can actually do a better job at it and hopefully put that person on the song.
Yeah. All I'm going to say is that...
Let me be your manager.
He got... The video got 55 million 64. Views. Okay, but the video got 55 million views in the first 4 hours that it was put on YouTube. He broke his own record. So,
congratulations
to Childish Gambino, also known as Danny Glover. Like, I am... Donald Glover, sorry. Sorry, Donald. Donald for Spider-Man, right? But I do love Donald Glover. But I just want to say I am proud of him for trying to make some sort of step towards something. You know, standing for something, having a vision and putting it out there and sharing it with the world. And because it is literally being shared with the world. So congratulations on that.
Exactly.
Definitely no hate there at all.
Yeah, no hate at all on that end. And for me, you know what I mean? The young brother's coming out there, you know, he's giving his outlook, you know, on what he sees and how he portrays the reality of what's been given to him and the knowledge that he knows of, you know.
And that's doing what hip-hop does.
You know what I mean? That's what he's doing as an artist for himself. And to show the world, like I say, he's using his star power. That was the greatest thing I ever seen, to use your star power like he did, to portray, to show somebody something that's not really paying attention in the world, what's really going on.
Yeah. And he's doing it all over, you know, because he's a producer, writer, now rapper, you know, visual mind opener, all types of stuff. You know, people are probably going to start labeling him a revolutionary next. You know, he's all over the world.
I just want him getting rid of the genius. The genius, right. I can't do that.
Yeah, you know, I think...
They use that too freely.
Yeah, I think what we can say about that is that he does many, many things very well. Instead of like, oh, we see a lot of rappers in TV, but how many of them are actual really good actors or actresses, you know? That is just like a cameo type thing.
I'm wondering how he suffered in them pants. I'm sorry. I've heard of Met Huggers before, but I never heard of Nut Resuscitators before.
And to actually do the dance, like, you know? How do you roll like that?
Is that the reason why he was making them faces?
No. Well, actually, what I've researched is that the outfit that he had on, not just the pants, but the fact, because a lot of people had something to say about him not having a shirt on, but what that was supposed to represent is showing his black skin and his vulnerability. So that's what that was supposed to be about. But
I saw a beard, really.
But there was a lot of, you know, the pants were kind of tight. The whole yellow shoes thing, and I've been reading like a lot on it, you know, even since we've been having this discussion. A lot of people are saying absolutely nothing that we have said tonight about this video. They're talking about how the video represents Michael Jackson.
Oh, Lord.
That has become the second big thing about, they're saying the resemblance between the video and Michael Jackson. Oh, Michael Jackson dances on top of cars. Oh, Michael Jackson, you know.
Michael Jackson tore up the car.
Yeah, right. No. Yeah. Michael Jackson stood, you know, would kind of stand in a weird way. That's not a Jim Crow thing. That was a Michael Jackson dance. Like, so people are comparing the video to Michael Jackson's video in 1991, Black and White.
That was after his spin. Come on. You know, right?
Yeah.
Hey,
Michael Jackson, you know why they say it's Michael Jackson? Because at the end, if you really pay attention, when he gets in their car, he starts dancing. Actually, the dance he's doing is Mr. James Brown himself.
I thought so.
If people really understand the music of it all, that's Mr. James Brown himself, because he says, get on up. Yep. If you listen to him, he says,
he's cutting a rug, just like James Brown. Do you know, James Brown wasn't like how most people dance. They dance all loose and stuff. James Brown, man, you know, he get down like grandpa at the club, you know what I'm saying? He ain't gonna move too much, he's gonna break it down.
This is radio, I would just like to say he is actually dancing. I need y'all to know he is actually dancing right now.
So, I break it down like James Brown too. Shit.
There's James Brown dance movements going on in the studio. I just like to put that out there.
Oh, wow.
But yeah, you know, so people have decided, there are people out there who have just completely decided to neglect all of the obvious things that are there and are like, you know what? We're just going to say, we're then going to use the video black and white, which is ironic because it is so black and white what is being, like, done in this video that they're like, no, this is black and white, Michael Jackson all over again. That's what he's doing. I get it. This is America.
Sally, what's your final thoughts on
The message has been said so many times.
Right. What's your final thoughts, Sally? What's your final thoughts about the video?
Like I said, the message has been played so much, from self-destruction video, even the... So what's the name of that? The one I sent you. The poem. The revolution will not be televised. Right. That video.
Right.
It shows the violence and everything. And it's not even depicted violence. It's the actual violence of those footages that went down. So, like I said, people have been seeing this for years and years and years, but we gotta start doing something about it. Right. 2018. And if you talk to the older people, they'll tell you the only things that have changed has been you can vote, you can sit where you want to sit, and we can go to the same schools, and you go. That's it.
Right.
So something has got to change around here.
And you know, I want to ask you to take that.
Something has got to change.
I actually want to take that point right there and bring attention to, we're in the beginning stages, but I've been working with some fellas about actually creating a stronger political party. You know, we don't really actually have a political party that's for, you know, the disenfranchised. Every political party is ran by the fortunate, by the most fortunate. Forget fortunate, by the most fortunate. Even the Democrat Party is ran by the elite. And, you know, they came out with the Tea Party. So we're actually working with some cats that want to create their own political party, and we're looking for any kind of support. So if you're looking to actually get in touch with and get some information about that, please hit me up on Facebook. You can find me as Shakur Millet, or you can find me as the Southside Bosses, or my group True Heritage or Economic Salvation. We definitely want to get some like-minded individuals who have some knowledge of law or the political system. That way, because we've been fighting the fight. You know, I always had the idea that the Black Panthers put Barack Obama into office, but that was until we actually seen his presidency. That changed my mind completely. But what the Black Panthers did, or was able to go underground and then build something to where they was able to put somebody in the White House. Which I think
that's real deep.
Yeah, no, see, I think that would be a lot.
We need old school Black Panthers for that one.
Right, not this new Black Panther Party stuff.
We gotta
go back to the old school way, man.
Right.
The old school Panthers gotta
come. Because these ones want to march, and I'm not with marching unless y'all want to do this like we taking this city to city.
Right, I feel
you.
You know what I mean? I'm not for the free entertainment.
You know what I mean? Because we can't do the March thing no more, because we're in the age of purge. You know what I mean? They brought the movies out for a reason.
Right.
You know what I mean? So, hey, if you don't have your shit together, some shit don't go wrong. You know what I'm saying? Because this is the time and age for it. You know what I mean? And everything is looking at the age. You know what I mean? Because I come from a heritage, you know, a lot of my family is from the older Black Panther Revolution. You know, you know me, Eric, from back in the days, you know. Right. A lot of my family come from that era, man, from up in Ohio and Cleveland and Akron way, you know what I mean? So a lot of the folk in my family, you know what I mean, I've learned so much through it, you know what I mean? And it's a lot of things that a lot of people don't really understand. How powerful that we really are if we just open our mouths, you know what right. I mean? We need, you know, people like us on this line tonight, you know what I mean, doing what we're doing, you know, because they listening. They always listening 24/7, so I love to stir up the pot, you know what I mean? They call us crabs anyway, so I might as well get the water hot. So, you know, hey, that's how it go in the world. If we have many people like ourselves doing what we do, 24/7, 7 days a week, and all our heads and minds were together, this world would be a different place, you know? And that's what we need to start basing it on. That's why I try to teach my kids, you know, about the errors of it all, so they can be able to learn and understand something and not just think it's just what you see nowadays, because what you see is not reality, it's just what you see. So, that's real. You know,
and you better learn your history, because that is repetitious.
Right.
Exactly.
Right.
You know what I mean?
We are definitely, and we're going backwards. That's the same.
Going backwards. That's all it is.
We as a human race, we started off as the smartest human beings ever. The smartest creatures on this world. Built pyramids, things that last centuries. Now we can't build stuff that lasts 3 years.
Right. Exactly.
That part.
You buy a smart TV that lasts you a year or two. But you gotta pay attention to your history. If you buy a Samsung, or if you buy a Sony, or you buy a RCA, they last forever. You know what I'm saying? You gotta know what you're doing. You know what I mean? Because that's the way this world is ran. This world is ran on repetition. If it's not exactly, if you go into a store and you say, okay, I know what I want. Okay, but you go in the store and you know what you want, but you come out with things you don't need, right. Then you didn't know what you want. You know? That's just how it go. And us as people, we need to all bind together and just because we have the power, but people are so afraid because, the government has more than us, but they don't realize that we are the government. Because if we don't put those people got the money, but if the people don't do, or if the people don't function, they don't make that money.
Not real.
Yeah. I think that movie Vendetta. If Vendetta said it best, not our government should be afraid of us.
Exactly.
Because if we don't move, we don't do nothing. Nobody makes money.
Right.
If the United States was to stand still and say we're not doing nothing, do you know the government will get scared as hell?
Right.
First thing they gonna do is what? They gonna lock us down on martial law. They gonna throw us in camps and slavery will start hardcore all over again.
See,
because you know why? Because they want control.
Right. Now that all boils down to one thing though. We all gotta understand that we have a choice in the matter of what goes on. We are still in that point where we think we don't have a choice. We think that Hillary and Trump were our only choices. I ain't got no opinion on that either. Or I don't give a fuck about either one of them, you know. But at the end of the day, they were not our only choices. And I'm not talking about Bernie Sanders, and I'm not talking about that other Republican chick that they was talking about, or that other Democratic chick. I don't care about all that. We had choices. We had choices to go to that poll and say we want a whole revamp of the government.
Jillian Stiles, was that it? Yeah,
but
you're right.
No, we have to have that choice individually before we can have that voice collectively. Which is what matters.
And the government does need to be revamped, because in all actuality, when government was created, it was not created to include people of color.
Exactly. The original 13th Amendment said that. The original 13th Amendment, yeah, they took it out. They took it out, but they made it clear as day they didn't want us.
Sure, Scott versus Dredd, they still living off of that. We aren't even really considered a citizen.
Right.
If you want to be honest.
Now they try to say that
Scott versus Dredd, until that decision gets appealed, we are not citizens. We are not even human beings.
Well, see, this is, I don't understand how it works in the courtroom, but I know whenever you talk to a legal professional, they always bring up the 13th and the 14th Amendment overturn the Dred Scott case, but at the same time, it never was actually stated. It was never actually in any case law mentioned. All they're saying is they're going off of conjecture. I need to see the case law that says that the 13th and the 14th Amendment overturns the Dred Scott case. Until
there
then, the
none.
Dred Scott case
there
is
none.
There right. is none.
Right. So that's
they're
all
not going to give you that.
And that's what they are using to justify killing us at such alarming rates. We are not human beings, so therefore, they are not killing a human being. They're putting an animal down.
Mm-hmm. We just tended a species.
We lived out our two-fish bite or whatever the fuck we were supposed to be. Like,
and apparently now their age is 12.
Right. But this was a great conversation. I'm glad we was able to have you two online. We actually would love to have y'all back for different shows. Fallon, we're going to get you in touch with Connie, and I actually want you to talk to Star here. She also has a show. She actually has a Mother's Day show. I don't know if I'm reminding her. She has a Mother's Day show. So I don't know if you're going to be free on Sunday, but you're more than welcome to join her.
Yes, you are more than welcome to join me on my show.
Yes, you are.
FSE, which is
this is right, people. I heard the saltiness in that one.
Yes.
But, I don't know if I want to come on now.
Yeah, but that's like going to be a whole nother topic. My show is much, much lighter. But I do like to talk to mostly women, and especially black women, because I feel that a lot of us need a talking to in more recent times. And some of us need to start listening to each other. So it's a little lighter, it's a little fun, and this Mother's Day we are going to have a special for all the mothers and man mothers, which apparently is a thing, and we're going to talk about that.
To hell it is.
on the internet.
Well, that if you're a single parent, you're a mother and father, so you get to play both roles. I am a firm believer in that.
Hey,
if you are a single father, happy Mother's Day to you.
Yeah, no, I believe in playing both roles, but I don't believe in this man-mom shit. No, you're going to have to come up with a new name for that.
We're going to save that conversation for Sunday.
New title. Man, don't stand for that shit.
Man-mom.
You know what? Keep playing. I'm gonna go get you a romper.
Hey,
little romper.
Oh, Lord. I'm gonna cut it right in half too.
Oh my God.
That way I have a shirt and a short set.
No. No. You gonna tuck it in? That's the same.
But anyway, Candy Liquor, I know you say you got some projects that you're working on, correct?
Yeah, so, I got a couple of things going on, you know what I mean, out here. I got one coming up here soon, you know what I mean? I'm finna do something for the kids, you know, me and my 8-year-old daughter, you know, Daria, and I want to put a song out here for the kids. You know, and the name of the song is called The Munchies. You know what I mean? It's all about, you know how kids come home, first thing they do, they want a snack, right?
Right.
So,
yeah.
You know what I mean? Like,
everybody
gonna
be able to make it.
We're gonna put it down for the 2018 and show these kids out here, you know, give them a little something. But me personally, I have my own music that's coming out here soon. I'm working on the project. The name of the song is called Think Again. It's pretty much something like, you know, what's going on with this video thing, you know what I mean? Because Think Again is basically a song that I'm bringing out, telling everybody, you know, the time has come for people to move on, live their lives inside a new zone. No more crying, no more tears, no more fears, because this is what it is. So, you know, think again.
And you're still in Corpus,
So hey man, I'm an R&B thing. I do the R&B thing. I got something for the ladies coming out also called Better Than Sugar. So hey, I do it all, you know what I mean? And I'm gonna put myself on the thing, and you know, hey.
So you're gonna
try out this music.
You're gonna enter that video for Think Again into the This Is America contest, right?
That's a good idea. You know what I mean? So I may have to go and break that down. You know what I mean?
Already.
And see if I can get.
Who's gonna be the judges?
You for one, Fallon. You for one.
Oh, I would be a judge too. I'll put my little glasses on and everything. But I was asking. Yeah, you're still in Corpus, and you said you're gonna do a song for the kids. I think that is so great.
Yeah.
Being somebody that was born in Corpus and raised there, and with everything that Corpus has recently lost, I don't really want to go into that, but with everything Corpus has recently lost, it is really good to hear that that you're kind of doing something for the kids and showing them that we still have a community there, because we've been losing it for so long.
You're sure right, Mama. You know what I mean? I grew up in Hillcrest. It ain't no more Hillcrest.
I know. Yeah, I missed it. So, like,
you know,
when I left Corpus, it was there, and now when I go back home, I don't know. Like, I didn't grow up in Hillcrest, but I'm originally from the West Side, raised in the Bluff, and then went back to the West Side, you know, in high school, and they said that the West Side just completely changed, and North Side is no longer there.
Yep.
Well, Hillcrest is no longer there, so I don't know how home I'm going to feel the next time I get to go visit, but...
Yeah, because there's not much of nothing, but you know what I mean? I look at it like this, you know, I got all the memories in my head, and I'm gonna put it in my music, and you know, I'm going to do what I do, you know what I mean? And that's what I do, and I'm going to talk about my city, and I'm going to rep my city, you know, as long as I live, you know what I mean? Because that's what I got to do, you know what I mean? And hopefully people feel me. Cause I always been trying to be a deep individual with my music, and I'm just trying to come out here and do something different, you know, for the city, man, and for the world to hear, man. I do music different. Eric know my music, my style. I never do a song the same. I make everything different, cause I sing all kinds of things. I'm a vocalist, so I'm not a rapper. I'm a vocalist.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? So I sing. So you know what I mean? Yeah, if you want to get country with it, I sang. You know what I mean? So, so you know what I mean?
Well,
I can go from the era of singing ballads like Luther to coming back and singing like you know, ballads like Alicia Keys or Jewel Scott. You know, and I can get deep with you just like anybody else in the game. You know what I mean? And I also write. So if anybody looking for a writer, holler at your boy.
Most definitely.
Already, man. That's what I like to hear, dog. We always got to be working out here, especially if you want to make some progress, you know. That, you know, that, like Childish Gambino was saying at the end of his video, dancing on top of them old model cars, you know. We ain't making no progress, so.
Yeah.
Fallon, you definitely
correct.
We ain't
got to make no progress.
Yeah, Fallon, you definitely right. We definitely need to start implementing solutions instead of just talking about problems. And I'm hoping that everybody get that out of this video. I mean, if you don't play that, you don't really have to like the video, but I definitely hope you get that point, because if you can get that point, then we can move forward. You gotta understand that there is some things that we have to work on, and once we understand that, we can come up with solutions, we have to make solutions, and we can have a better world for our children. I'm not trying to wait for my children to become of age so they can fix these problems. That's my nightmare.
Exactly.
That's my nightmare. My children have to fix the problems that I face today, and that means that I didn't do a damn thing for them.
Mm-hmm. Right.
This is one of the reasons why I refuse to have any.
I hear you. Yeah, you made that decision up in high school, didn't you?
I told you, no, I'm not having none. As long as this world is the way it is,
hey.
I'm going to jail one way or another, and I'm not about to do it.
I feel you.
I'm not about to do it. I will be Oprah Winfrey and beloved if the situation comes down to it. I'll kill my own child before I let you touch him.
Uh-huh. I feel you on that. I feel you. Well, everybody, it was great having y'all on. We're going to go ahead and end it out. We're going to play some more music, you know what I'm saying, for all the listeners, all y'all listeners out there. If you haven't already done it yet, go to sbcmovement.com, hit that follow button. Go to our Facebook page at Southside Boss Connection and find our group page at Southside Bosses. Like our page, join our group. Find True Heritage, find Bars Matter. Me and Fallon are administrators of Bars Matter, so y'all make sure y'all find that one too, because that's where it gets loose at. You feel me? We talk
hashtag bars.
Yes, and we hold no bars, so don't come thinking we're going to be thinking about your feelings.
I'll tell you, you can come promote, you can network, you can do whatever you want to do. You can talk about the artist, discuss, I don't care. Just no garbage.
Right.
No garbage.
No garbage.
That's real.
If your music is trash, I will tell you it's trash and I'm about to delete it.
Yes, get off your feelings, take it as a business advice and redo the song.
Yes, sir, yes, sir. Well, I know who I need to call when I'm ready to get my music out there. Oh, yeah. I'm going to call you, girl.
I'm saying so, because as soon as I get this podcast ready, I expect you to be one of my guests.
Jesus.
I'll give you an interview.
he know how to hit me up, man. He know how to hit me up. You know what I mean? I'll put it out there.
Already, y'all make sure y'all send y'all friend requests. You know what I'm saying? I want everybody to know this is what we do. Southside Boss Connection. We link bosses together. So y'all make sure y'all link up. And all my fans out there, we're going to get it going right now. We got a little bit of that Childish Gambino. So if y'all listening right now, we're going to, and if you have, I know this is probably nobody in the world, but if you haven't heard the song yet, you're about to hear it right now. If you haven't, and I actually suggest you go see the video. And tell us what you think about it. Hit our chat box. Hit our Facebook. Hit our Twitter. Hit our Instagram. Southside Boss. I'm going to go ahead and link out. Fallon, it was great having you on. Candy Lick, it was great having you on. And as always, Connie, it was great having the pal. Pleasure having you on as well. We love your point of view. And Star, I keep about to say the government name and put her on blast out of feds come get her. You know, I ain't trying to have a feds come get her. But Star, it was great having you with us tonight. And we look forward to your show, Passion Hour, on Sunday night. We're going to be talking about the lovely mothers out there. Great having y'all on. This is the Southside Bosses. Mr. E. Boss of the Southside Bosses tuning out. Y'all have a great night. You heard?
What love.
B.O.S.S. Southside Bosses.
Slipping now. Look what I'm whipping now. This is America. Don't catch you slipping now. Don't catch you slipping now. Look what I'm whipping now. This is America. Don't catch you slipping now. Look how I'm living now. Police be tripping now. Yeah, this is America. Guns in my area. I got the strap. I gotta carry 'em. Yeah, yeah, I'ma go into this. Yeah, yeah, this is Gorilla. Yeah, yeah, I'ma go get the bag. Yeah, yeah, or I'ma get the pad. Yeah, yeah, I'm so cold like, yeah.
Yeah,
I'm so dull like, yeah.
Woo.
We gon' blow like, yeah.
Girl.
Slipping now. Look what I'm whipping now. This is America. Don't catch you slipping now. Don't catch you slipping now. Look what I'm whipping now. Look how I'm geeking now. I'm so fitted. I'm on Gucci. I'm so pretty.
Yeah, yeah.
I'm gonna get it. Watch me move. This is selling. That's a tool.
Yeah.
On my Kodak.
Woo. Black.
Ooh, know that.
Yeah,
yeah. Ooh, get it. Get it. Get it. Work it.
Yeah.
100 bands. Contraband. I got the plug on who a hawker.
Whoa.
They gonna find you like Waka. Blah.
Ooh, America. I just checked my following. Listen. You motherfuckers owe me.
Get your money, black man.
Black man.
Get your money, black man.
Black man.
Get your money, black man.
Black man.
Get your money.
This is the revolutionary hour.
Every day trying to get it. We live and die for the dollar.
Unlimited.
They say money is the root.
Let's get it.
Feeling like Omar Epps when Pac fell off the roof.
Got the
live with no regrets. What a real nigga do. That's cause and effect. Some choose to break the rules. I'm blessed with the Jews. Use the pain as my fuel.
Uh-huh.
10 youngers on the corner pushing work. Call them muse. Shawty rather catch a dollar. Learn that shit in school. On the crime by the bills. Rent too much overdue. I hear the money calling niggas. It's time to make power moves.
Power moves.
If the streets is what you choose, what you choose. Just know one day your dog may turn on you.
Your dog may turn on you.
For that dollar, I'ma let the angels holler.
Holler.
I see it every day. These youngins out here starving, looking for a better way. Unaware of the knowledge. I know tomorrow ain't promise. I hope God hears calling. We live and die for the dollar. We live and die for the dollar. We live and die for the dollar.
We live and die for the dollar.
Single mother struggling with two, one in the oven. The pressure's on daddy, not home all of a sudden. She hold it down, wearing a crown. Can't tell her nothing like a jungle. Makes her wonder how she keep from going under. Convicted felon lost hope on his last appeal. Moving dope to provide his fam a decent meal. God, is he wrong for surviving, getting it how he lived? Doing 34, birdie locked behind the cold steel. Working the white man's job, they treat you like a slave. You feel the pain on your back without the whips and chains. This shit ain't designed for you, it's all commercial gain. We live and die for the dollar, call it minimum wage. Dear God, these crackers trying to kill us. Bring down Exodus before they squeeze another trigger. Technology brainwashing all my little children. Planting bad seeds, corrupting minds by the millions.
Do you feel
it every day? These youngins out here starving, looking for a better way. Unaware of the knowledge. I know tomorrow ain't promise. I hope God hears calling. We live and die for the dollar.
We live and die for the dollar.
We live and die for the dollar. We live and die for the dollar.
We live and die for the dollar.
We live and die for the dollar.
Something you can always feel.
something real, something that you can feel. Okay. Bring back that vibe, y'all. Uh-huh. Out past the Lauryn Hill. Yes, nowadays, everybody got swag. Pull the max out, they gon' mad. Step on they brand new sneakers. Okay. Better run, cause that's your tag. Oops, I mean your buttocks. They'll kill you for them Reeboks. Especially them brand new J's. They praise them ugly high tops. But this ain't about no sneakers. By the way, I ain't no preacher. I am not of this world. I am an ugly creature. But God loves ugly, don't he? Don't think so, you baloney. Come for them dirty ninjas. Matthew 9:13, homie. Which baby poo-poo don't stink? You a simp cause you got big bang. Raised up in the house of God. Got dipped in a tank. You full of it like Easter Sunday pulpit. Overzealous, lacking knowledge. Cause you knew in it, but you doing it. But you ruin it. That's right, I said it. Over pursuing it. Don't know what you're talking about. Shut your mouth and put some glue in it. Some say he real with it. Either way, gotta deal with it. Take a pill, cause I'm ill with it. Ain't a thief, but I'm stealing it. Stick killing it. My TV's evil. What happened to these people? Got him waiting outside for the sequel. Yeah, Simon says jump in the drawer. Says sure. The tube is full of garbage, but your brain wants more. Dummies are rapping. Teeny beanies are clapping. Tell me, how did this happen? Corporate fingers are snapping. They think it's beautiful, but ain't suitable. That's my opinion. I think they're evil, and they're trying to turn us to their minions. But I will ride before I go and buy it. My gosh, turn is a tire. These rappers should retire and turn in their pensions and never ever mention they did this for a living, most of all for attention and a little bit of paper. Their moment was a vapor. You're here one day and gone the next. I'm gonna catch you later.
Again, yeah. Shorty says she wet again, yeah. My girl says she wet again, yeah. Yeah, Shorty says she wet again. Try Mr. J, baby.
Oh, don't want for. Oh, she would know. Oh, see what best standing fan. Me fan who ni hoy. Oh, don't want for. Oh, she would know. What's your best standing fan? But wine. Wet again, wet again, wet again. My girl a tell me she wet again. Wet again, wet again. Wet again, wet again, wet again. My girl a tell me she wet again. Wet again, wet again. She say she dey sweat inside the snow. Anytime shorty see me, she wanna get inside the pool. Be a penalty shootout. She wanna take me down the riverbank. If only I promise to dive inside. She open Jerusalem gate. Say make her come inside. What's my speed in the meter? My spark in the engine. My plug in the heater. I'm gonna be the cause. Wet again, wet again, wet again. My girl tell me she wet again. Wet again, wet again. Wet again, wet
again. My girl are telling me she wet again, wet again, wet again. I don't want for, or she wouldn't know. I see what best standing fan, me from who ni who. I don't want for, or she wouldn't know. I see what best standing fan, but wine, wine. Wet again, wet again, wet again. My girl are telling me she wet again, wet again, wet again. Wet again, wet again, wet again. My girl are telling me she wet again, wet again, wet again. Wet again, wet again, wet again. My girl are telling me she wet again, wet again, wet again. Wet again, wet again, wet again. My girl are telling me she wet again, wet again, wet again. She wet again, you know. JMJ.
In my conscience, I'm taking no sorts with no loss. I'm finding some peace when the meds came. I'm finding some peace when the chairs came. I'm a provider, that's the best thing. I do it for y'all, that's a mad thing. Yeah, yeah, do it for y'all, that's a mad thing. I stay on my job, that's a mad thing. Give it to them hard, that's a mad thing. I stack all these racks, that's a mad thing. I puff on these packs, that's a mad thing. Ain't no going back, that's a mad thing. We all staying strapped, that's a mad thing.
Forced into a situation for obliteration. Stuck us in the projects and started us racing. Kissing up the game like we about to hit a base. Stacking money, cause we have to show them what they really facing. Invest, invest in a motherfucking vest. We about to go to war and it's never gonna rest. I know there's no peace in the streets of America, a land where the dark people stress. Oh yeah, it's one of them things. At the time that we hang, I can see all the pain in the eyes of the brain. It fuels my fire like a kerosene blaze. When I learn about your heritage and workers on the slave. Different answers, I did that, then I can do this. Definitely prove this, niggas on his own shit. Taking my heritage, I'm trapped with that metal piece. So your motherfucker better cease and desist. Cover this diamonds with a little wild home. Went to a diamond by a carpet, five tries. Have a coke and a smile. If you not with the movement, I bleed for my people every inch, every mile. Fly away, don't like what I say. I'm coming for mine and you all gonna pay. I can see you afraid with a little bunny yankers and a mule that you promised yesterday.
Okay,
I do it for my people, not equal, we original. Kinda make sense while you motherfuckers copy style. I can break it down like a motherfucking pound. Never round if you really wanna get it right now. I do it for my people, not equal, we original. Kinda make sense while you motherfuckers copy style. I can break it down like a motherfucking pound. I'm around if you really wanna get it right now.
Yeah. When they say more money, more problems, I'm thinking I don't got an option. I'm working on facing my conscience. I'm taking no sauce with no loss. I'm finding some peace when the meds came. I'm finding some peace when the chains came. I'm a provider, that's the best thing. I do it for y'all, that's a mad thing. Yeah, yeah, do it for y'all, that's a mad thing. I stay on my job, that's a mad thing. Give it to them hard, that's a mad thing. I stack all these racks, that's a mad thing. I buff on these packs, that's a mad thing. Ain't no going back, that's a mad thing. We all stay strapped, that's a mad thing.
I ain't watching treated to kill it, I say it's all. They can't face it like a maker, the best of two damn songs. Call the nigga in the cross, they master what's called bumps. Fucking bust up at the job, the cycle is not long. Not to mention prison, not living, they kill you so long. Can you see the plan, killing native people with a call? It's awful, but no one is left staring in awe. We so decent, the top children on kill them all. This world crumbling like Mary Jane. Just to keep my focus clear while I'm driving the left lane. The woods switch lane, but it's so much damn pain. In the past, raining on the brain is different from the pain. This ain't my only excuse, this is how they made me. The six people in my head and they all hate me. But I'm a soldier, you motherfuckers can't take me. On everything I love is the truth, you can't break me. The souls of my ancestors, listen to my spirit. If you hear it, it's enough to make you care what fuckers fear it. My life is like a bus and I'ma be the one to steer it. I'm fighting for my people and everything till we clear it. The march of progress and you know we fed up. You really gonna hate us when we get our bread up. Send up black nation, I'm getting impatient. It's time to make the doctor really see the sick patient.
When they say more money, more problems, I'm thinking I don't got an option. I'm working on facing my conscience. I'm taking no sucks with no loss. I'm finding some peace when the meds came. I'm finding some peace when the chairs came. I'm a provider, that's the best thing. I do it for y'all, that's a mad thing. Yeah, yeah, do it for y'all.
for y'all, that's on everything. I stay on my job, that's on everything. Give it to them hard, that's on everything. I stack all these racks, that's on everything. I puff on these plaques, that's on everything. Ain't no going back, that's on everything. We all staying strapped, that's on everything.
Trying to get it. We live and die for the dollar. Yeah.
Link unlimited.
They say money is the root.
Let's get it.
Feeling like Omar Epps when Pac fell off the roof.
Got the
live with no regrets. What a real nigga do. That's cause and effect. Some choose to break the rules. I'm blessed with the Jews. Use the pain as my fuel.
Uh-huh.
10 youngers on the corner pushing work. Call them muse. Shawty rather catch a dollar, learn that shit in school. Mama crying about the bills, rent too much overdue. I hear the money calling niggas, it's time to make power moves.
Power moves.
If the streets is what you choose, just know one day your dog may turn on you.
Your dog may turn on you.
For that dollar, I'ma let the angels holler.
Holler.
I see it every day. These youngins out here starving, looking for a better way. Unaware of the knowledge. I know tomorrow ain't promised. Oh God, hear us calling. We live and die for the dollar.
We live and die for the dollar.
We live and die for the dollar.
For the dollar, for the dollar.
We live and die for the dollar.
We live and die for the dollar.
We live and die for the dollar. Single mother struggling with two, one in the oven. The pressure's on daddy, not home all of a sudden. She hold it down, wearing a crown. Can't tell her nothing like a jungle. Makes her wonder how she keep from going under. Convicted felon, lost hope on his last appeal. Moving dope to provide his fam a decent meal. God, is he wrong for surviving, getting it how he lived? Doing 34, birdie locked behind the cold steel. Working the white man's job, they treat you like a slave. You feel the pain on your back without the whips and chains. This shit ain't designed for you, it's all commercial gain. We live and die for the dollar, call it minimum wage. Dear God, these crackers trying to kill us. Bring down Exodus before they squeeze another trigger. Technology brainwashing all my little children. Planting bad seeds, corrupting minds by the million.
Do you feel
it every day? These youngins out here starving, looking for a better way. Unaware of the knowledge. I know tomorrow ain't promised. I hope God hears calling. We live and die for the dollar.
We live and die for the dollar.
We live and die for the dollar. We live and die for the dollar.
We live and die for the dollar.
We live and die for the dollar.
This is the Revolution Radio.